When a branch of the Women's Cooperative Guild was being formed, a kind lady told me that she thought it would do me good to go to a meeting once a week and leave my worries behind me for a few hours, to leave the washing and ironing that I did for a living too. She was right. It meant a long walk to the meeting and back, but it was worth it for something fresh to listen to and something to think about all week. I was not used to working women managing their own meetings. I'd been to mothers' meetings where ladies came and lectured on domestic affairs in the workers' homes, things it was impossible for them to understand. I've boiled over many times at the things I've been obliged to listen to without being allowed to ask a question. At the Guild, we discussed everything. I was elected onto the management committee of my society, and I'm proud of the fact that I was the first woman my society had ever sent to represent them at a cooperative union congress. I don't think anyone at that congress felt their responsibilities more than I did. There were things that had to be voted on that were left to the judgment of the delegates. Oh, I was so anxious to do right. I was pleased when I gave my report that my committee were satisfied.